So in previous class we discussed about few problems, then continuation of the problem. So next problem is, so here to determine the refractive index of benzene, so find the refractive index of benzene. If what is the given condition here? If the critical angle is given, if the critical angle is 42 degrees. So actually I told you we have trigonometrical ratios in mathematics, sine, cos, tan, main important. For that you have the values, you have to study it. So that is sine 0, sine 30, sine 45, understand, sine 90, sine 60, like that values you already know. But 42, yesterday I told you 0.75, like that inverse values that will be there, all had to seen by logarithm book. So had observed in that logarithm book, these values will be there. But what is our bad thing, this logarithms are not provided to 10th class students. So just to have to recognize or remember that values. So here also critical angle 42 degrees will be given, it will be taken in sine, that's why sine, we consider sine 42 degrees, the value to be considered sine 42. So according to the logarithm book I will write this value. This value will be 0.6691. So what is this value? 0.6691. So from where I will get this value? From logarithm book. Okay, so according to the logarithm book only I will write. So if this value is not there, we can't calculate that. That's why compulsory we need this value. So refractive index and what is the given critical angle will be given. What is the relation between them? Refractive index n is equal to 1 by sin c. N is equal to 1 by sin c. That's the formula. First you had write it always formula application to write what application you had to do. So here application is n is equal to 1 by sin c. Here what is the given? Critical angle c is given. What is that c value? 42 degrees. Then you had to find the RI of benzene, refractive index, that is n is equal to how much. So once again to be recall the formula, what is formula? N is equal to 1 by sin c, to be recall it, that is equal to 1 by sin c means sin 42 degrees. What is the value of sin 42? What is the value of sin 42 value? 0.6691 will be there. That value we have to write here. So 0.6691. Now this is equal to remove the point here, 1 by 6691 by. So 1 after point, 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros are there. 1, 2, 3, 4 after point, 4 decimals are there. So after the decimal 4 digits are there, then you can write zeros. Then what happens, according to mathematics it goes up, that means 10 thousands by 691. So to make the calculation this value, so roughly you have to do this 10,000 divided by 691. I had to get it. At first it goes to one time, what is that? 6691. So here 10 9 0 9 3 so 3, you get this value 3390. Then again to keep the point, had to keep zero. Approximately it goes to 5 times. 5 ones are 5 5 nines are 45. So approximately to consider 6691 into 5 to make, what you get? 5, 45, 30, 34, 34 you get. So approximately more than value of this, that's why you consider with 4. So approximately you get 1.5. So 4 times, 4 ones are 4, 4 nines are 36, 4 six are 24, 24, 27, 4 6 are 24, 26. Now 6, 8, 2, 10, 3, here 8, so 2, 10, 12, 6. So already point will be there to keep 0. So approximately it goes to approximately to consider with 9 times. 9. 9 ones are 9, 9 nines are 81, 9 4, 9 6 are 54, 54 plus 9, 63, so approximately to consider as 9. So that means what do you get? 1.49. This is the refractive index of benzene, or otherwise this to be nearly 1.5, to write as 1.5. This about the, if critical angle will be given, I had to calculate the refractive index. Okay, this of one of the model, understand? So these values to be remembered, generally it will given in the question paper, if not to be remembered this values, very few. Yesterday on 0.75 one value I told, next value this one 0.669 belongs to sine 42 degrees. Okay, then another important problem in this will be, so another important, this is a very important for SSC students and also for ICSE also, this is an important problem, fifth question. So what is that fifth question means? Here to consider a light ray is incident on air liquid interface. So a light ray is incident, a light ray is incident on air and liquid interface, air and liquid interface, and interface at 40 degrees, interface at 40 degrees, sorry, interface at 45 degrees and refracted at, interface at 45 degrees and refracted at, and refracted at 30 degrees, refracted at 30 degrees. So this is the given condition. Then what is the refractive index of the liquid? Liquid refractive index you have to calculate. So what is the refractive index of liquid? What is the refractive index of liquid? One question. And in that, for what? So this is one question. And it's also another question will be given. For what angle of incidence will be the, for what angle of, what angle of incidence to be calculated, what angle of incidence will the angle between refracted ray and reflected ray be 90 degrees? Reflected ray be 90 degrees. So here to see the two questions are given in this. One is a light ray is incident on air liquid. So here two surfaces we had to consider. One is air, another one is liquid. In that 45 makes an angle of incidence here. Angle of incidence is 45 degrees and angle of refraction is 30 degrees. Then to calculate the refractive index of the liquid, liquid refractive index value to be calculated. Okay. So for what is the application you had to apply means n is equal to sin I by sin R application to be used to find the refractive index. Then next further question in it is, for what angle of incidence will the angle between the refracted ray and reflected ray will be 90 degrees? So total internal reflection takes place here. So the angles between this refracted and reflected will be 90 degrees. Then what is an angle of incidence will be takes place? That we have to calculate. So first of all, for this solution, I have to draw one simple application. So here, this is the interface. Interface means medium separator. Interface means what? Medium separator. Here, it is first medium air. it is another medium, liquid, air and liquid we had to consider. So refractive index of air is its n value, it is considered as n1, its n1 value is taken as 1, refractive index of air is considered as 1 and refractive index of enne iskondi n ikkada avasaram ledhu mana tarvata daniki vastundi avasaram ledhu here we have to calculate liquid refractive index only, no, so that's why no need to take refractive index of water. Okay, now here for next question we have to consider air and liquid will be there, this is the separator, medium separator. Now light ray will be produced with 45 degrees, so here the angle of incident ray, this angle of incident ray will be how much angle it takes, 45 degrees takes place, and it will be refracted towards the normal, no, rarer to denser medium it travels. So here refraction takes place with an angle of 30 degrees, so refracted ray will be taken as, refracted ray will be 30 degrees. Then you have to apply refractive index of the medium, n is equal to, according to Snell's law, this one sin I by sin O to be apply. Here I is equal to angle of incident, angle I is equal to 45 degrees, and angle R is equal to 30 degrees. Now substitute, then what is n value, n value is how much, substitute in this equation, what do you get, n is equal to sin 45 degrees by sin 30 degrees. Now what is the value of sin 45, according to mathematics the sin 45 value will be 1 by root 2 by sin 30 degrees will be 1 by 2, so 1 by root 2 by 1 by 2. Now what you get, two fractions will be there to form it as 2 by 2 root 2. Now to make the rationalization, so according to mathematics you know that rationalization factor, so to rationalize this what do you get, 2 by root 2 means it's rationalized, 2 root 2 by root 2. Now what do you get, 2 root 2 by 2 root 2 into root 2, we get as 2, so 2 gets cancelled, then n is equal to root 2 value will be 1.414. so what is the value of root 2, 1.414. therefore refractive index of liquid will be, here air is 1, to be remember liquid value will be 1.41, so therefore ri of liquid is equal to 1.414. one question is completed here. And another will be, what happens if the ray will be, so to consider if the ray will be reflected with 90 degrees angle, then what is the angle of incidence takes place, so here this angle of incidence to be calculated. So this is the refracted ray, but what happens if this incident and here reflects, it will be reflection also takes place, reflection with an angle of 90 degrees, what is the angle formed here, this angle will be 90 degrees angle it will be formed, then here to be calculate the I value. So for this consider as n1 medium, this n2 medium, n1 is equal to air 1, n2 is equal to 1.414, we calculated already, understand, to be taken that values. Now here total angle to be considered as, here this is the refracted angle or this is the refracted angle, or now what is the total angle in the triangle, I plus 90 degrees plus R is equal to 180 degrees, then I plus R is equal to 180 minus 90, then I plus R is equal to 90 degrees, I plus R value will be 90 degrees we get it. So R is equal to, from this to make R as a subject, R is equal to 90 minus I, R is equal to 90 minus I, so R value will be 90 minus I. Now according to Snell's law, n1 sin I is equal to n2 sin R, n1 sin I is equal to n2 sin R, n1 is 1 into sin I, that value had to calculate, I value only had to calculate, that's why sin I is equal to n2 1.414 into sine r, means sine of 90 minus I. Sine of 90 minus I to be considered. Now in that we have to make calculate the sine I value. So sine I value to be calculated means sine I is equal to 1.414 into sine of 90 minus I. According to mathematics it is called sine of 90 minus theta is cos theta. That means according to that to write as cos I. Remember that sine of 90 minus I consider as a cos theta. It is a mathematical formula, sine of 90 minus theta, it becomes as cos theta. Okay, so here I will be there to write as I. Now take that I this side, what do you get? Sine I by sine r is equal to 1.414. so sine I by cos I, sine I by cos I is equal to 1.414. sine by cos is equal to, according to trigonometry, tan. Sine by cos, it is a mathematical application, since sine by cos is equal to tan. Remember that is a mathematical formula. So hence sine by cos is taken as tan. Therefore tan i is equal to 1.414. then we can calculate I value only. I is equal to tan inverse of 1.414. tan inverse of 1.14. so according to logarithm table, this tan inverse of 1.4 value will be 54.4 degrees. By seeing the logarithm book, this tan inverse of 1.414 value will be 54.4 degrees. Therefore this angle of incident will be 54.4 degrees. Okay, so I had to continue in next class. Thank you.